Hi everyone, hello, 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 welcome, welcome, welcome back to farming. Good evening Ethan, good evening Mozilla, good evening Luke, how's it going? Oh, how is your Wednesday progressing? Luke, still got internet issues. Ah, oh, rubbish, you had those yesterday. Somehow I'm on the top of the combine. So as said last week, we are on the classic farming server, which is of course Dynamite Andy B's server. As you can see, we've got these old class 208s, Dominator, which is quite nice. We're on the North Brabant map, 1.4, one I've played for many, many hours. Let's just get in here and give this a go, and might as well finish off the harvest, you know. See how this goes. Oh. Hello, Sussex driver. Long time no see, bud. How you been? Whack-a-man. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Yeah. And I'm sure Andy B will be arriving sometime this evening. Until then, we're just going to go crazy. I've got Patrick working on the fields as well. As always, our ably assisted by Patrick. Hopefully Andy will turn up and actually give us some instruction of what he wants doing. If not, we're just gonna play it by ear and whatnot. As you can see, we've all got classic equipment, so it's all... Oh, and we've got drive control as well. Oh, that's gonna get some get used to. I've switched drive control off on my mini games, so it's gonna take a bit of time. Right, let's stick out the old, oops, old pipe. Finger trouble once more. It should have been long as well. Thank you. I'm not too bad actually. Very good, thank you, Sussex. It's very busy, very warm. All of a sudden, we seem to have gone incredibly warm this last day, or couple of days. I thought summer was over, autumn was here, but nope, it seems that summer has one more hot spell to throw at us. So I am currently, if you can hear a slight whirling or something, that's probably the fan blasting me with cold air. It's not negotiable, it's staying on. It's so warm, especially with the PCs trying to slowly cook me as well. If I remember rightly, this is non-collidable. Yes, it is. Cool. Oh, drive control. Or shuttle control on the drive control thingy. You know what I mean. Don't notice all day with the aircon truck. Yeah, well. I'm in a room with a window. That's all I've got, unfortunately. Don't have the luxuries of an air-conditioned truck. Sounds divine. Did I get everything? Oh, I missed a tiny little tuft. I thought I did. I thought I did. But yeah, we're gonna do some. We're gonna cross mix it with Andy's server and do some classic farming just to change it up a little bit. Keeps things a little bit more manual. Everything's a little bit smaller scale, and it keeps things interesting. Suffered for it when you get into the car. Yeah, yeah, I bet that car was like a little greenhouse sitting there all day in the sun. Now, my car is notoriously bad for that kind of thing, because what's worse is that it's got leather seats, which if you're wearing shorts, say goodbye to your skin. But B, it also has... the top of the gear stick is metal, so you go to change gear and you get the a palm impression burnt into the centre of your palm, a little bit like that guy who had the medallion from Raiders of the Lost Ark. Do you remember that, when he grabbed it and he'd been in the fire and it burnt that thingy and crystal onto his arm. It's kind of like that every time you change gear in the hot weather. It's a nightmare. What server is this? This is Dynamite Andy's B. This is the classic... I think it's the classic farming exile or classic exile farming. The details are on the same page on the website that the usual server is on as well. So all the details with a link to the mods there as well. A lot of the mods are crossoverable, if that's a word. But what I do, just to keep things simple, I always have different mod folders for in my farm sim directory. So, for example, for my server and for my single player game, I have my mods folder. Now, to join Andy's, I'll have a separate folder called Mods Andy. And then I'll just rotate them, and obviously you rename them when you want to play particular on a particular server, and that's the way I go around it. Saves all these mod corruptions and all sorts of craziness. Right, I think that field is done. Taff, my internet is slowly dying. After last night, I'm trying to reinstall IL2 Cliffs of Dover. It's still saying it'll take like 10 to 16 hours. Oh my goodness. You really are having some bad internet problems. Are you on dial-up by any chance? That's horrendous. I remember those days. And after every hour, dial-up used to hang up, then redial. Do you remember that? Oh, that's frustrating. There we go. Forgotten what aircon is. Hasn't worked at work. Oh, really? If that's not something to have a go at the boss about, I don't know what is. Gotta have your air conditioning working. Right, let's just have a quick check on what we got going on field-wise. So we've got a fair amount of stuff in there. Okay, here we go. So we own fields 2, 3, 49, 48, 4, 5, 6, 7, 46, 45, 35, 31, 3. Oh, yeah, we own quite a few fields. But they're all grass. They're all growing. Ready to harvest. Corn. We've got some corn over there. Right. We've got to try and find a corn harvester and we can get that done. But we'll probably pick some of that straw up first, I think. Guess we bring this back to the farm. Not sure where Andy stores these, but it's probably going to be on the farm, so we'll just do that. Taffbot got deleted his own link. You see, they don't show deleted for me. I don't know what's wrong with that. It's weird. It plays deleted for some people and not for others. Don't know why. Still a mystery to me. Ah, yeah, that Wacky Man. That's it. Join farm. Go to that website, that will give you the link in there. Log in and that should give you all the details for both. This is the classic one, so you want the classic. There's, oh, field 11. Okie dokie. Field 11, they say. Ah, oh, drive control. Let's go and get some canola then. Might as well get it all out of the way while we've got the class in action. Ooh, can I get through those signs? Oh yeah. Thread in the eye of the needle. And they got a cow sign here. Is that clippable? No. Okay, they're not clippable. Oh well. Panic over. Right. Let me just do something quickly. There we go. Right. Silly drive control. I'm going to make that mistake all night, I feel. It's lovely canola. Okay, Luke, no worries. Catch you later, bud. Whack-a-man, if you go to the website link, which was linked above, excuse me, after you did exclamation join farm, go to that website, and on there they'll take you to a page. You just have to quickly log in, create a free account. It's just to stop bots. It's nothing else. I don't spam you with mails or anything. And then it'll give you full details of the server, how to find it, all the mods listed as well. So that's, and there'll also be links to download the mods. Now on there there'll be my normal one, which is all laid out normally. There'll also be the classic server, and on the classic server there's a link right next to the server name. Click on that and it'll take you to the server page, and it'll list all the mods, the ones that are active and the ones that are not active. You just need to download the ones that are active, and then you are good to go. I see another class coming towards me. He's found another one. Okay. Let's try and dodge the trees. And we'll go this way around, I guess. Right. The nice thing is, these are quite small fields on this farm, so it doesn't feel like you're going round and around for ages. You can get through and feel like you've achieved something by completing a field relatively quickly. Good evening, Monster Guts. How are you, sir? Good to see you. Get out of the way of Patrick so he can keep going. That's got a nice curved edge to this field. Look at that! Oh, classic combines in action. Oh, he's got. I see mine's yellow. Oh, hang on. The field is turning. Turn with the field, Taff. Turn with the field. Last scene going past Amsterdam. So this is primarily a dairy map. This North Brabant was set up as a dairy farm, as obviously it's when I did my first real single player series for Farm Sim 15, which was pretty good. It's got the old classic Fords there, look at that. Now these are the little toy tractors I had when I was a kid, and I remember seeing these in the fields. There we go. 40% full, doing okay. Right, let's quickly go so I don't hold them up too much. Whoops, missed a bit. You can just tidy that bit up for me, that'd be great. Yes, look at these little beasts. Still see these amply working away in the fields this year. These old classes. I've seen older ones than this actually. There we go. Yeah, but I've got a yellow bit to my header, whereas Patrick's got the full class. Green and white one. So I'm not sure why I've got a yellow one. Maybe I've got a special one. Special one. Because I'm special. In many ways. Sadly, no class working around near you, monster. All John Deere. Oh, that's not a bad thing. Obviously, a John Deere hotspot, clearly. Yeah, we've got quite a mix round here. Yeah, class, you get a lot of... I've seen a couple of John Deere this year, actually, thinking about it. Trying to get a few, quite a few New Holland, actually. It's quite a big New Holland area around near me. I think you got quite a few outlets around here for New Holland. So you see the big old yellow New Holland. Actually, when I was driving to my parents early summer, it was probably July time, they had a New Holland demonstration in a couple of fields, not a million miles from my parents. Obviously, I saw it on the way to it. And they had some of the latest combines and stuff, and they were just doing, like, I don't know, it was like promo harvest or something. They're just like giving everything a test run with some early crops, which was quite interesting. So yeah, there's obviously New Holland is quite big around here, but there was plenty of class around here as well. JTav, hello. Good evening, sir. How's it going? I read your mail, JTav. Thank you ever so much. It's very kind. We'll talk about that further. So very, very kind of you. I haven't had time to reply. It's been one of those weeks, if you know what I mean. It's always been one of those weeks. But this week especially. Pretty much all the harvest has been completed round near me now. It's yeah, I think it's pretty much all done. Started ploughing the fields already. It's quite depressing this time of year, isn't it? Kids are going back to school, which means autumn is well and truly here. The fields start to turn brown. And you know winter's coming. Winter's coming. Not in the Game of Thrones way, just winter's coming. So one of those big John Deere articulated jobbies. Oh no, you don't see many of those around here. Don't, you see some huge equipment, but not much of that stuff. Right, how are we doing? 88% full. So we're getting there. There, there. Good old Patrick. He's picking up all my my missed bits. So you think I'm doing it really neatly and tidily. But no, he's just tidying up behind me, which is great. That's what you need. People have got your back. Anyway, Andy will turn up now. No, I didn't want you to harvest that. Whoops, sorry, Andy. I love how this tractor skips in it and the note of the engine goes upside. He goes meep 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 meep. Sounds like my girlfriend's cat. He's got a bit of a squeaker, that cat. It's a funny little thing. He doesn't meow properly. So what's everyone been up to on their Wednesday? Working? Is there people back to school? People back to work off their summer breaks, looking after the kids or whatever. Yeah, yeah. Everyone's fed up this week, aren't they? Yeah, I know. I feels it. Whoa, and I'm full. Oops. Haven't done that very well. There we go. Wednesday in September, yeah. Yep. I am, of course, trying to cheer myself up. And if anyone remembers, when I went to, back in Easter, I went to North Wales. Took the girlfriend, because she'd never been. We spent a long weekend in North Wales looking at all the sites and stuff. And I discovered a new cider called Taffy Apples. And I found out that they actually do it online. You can buy it online. So I bought some and it arrived yesterday. premium craft cider. Absolutely delicious. Hey, Whack-A-Man has joined. Welcome. He's in. Oh, now he's synchronizing. Yeah, it's absolutely delicious. I ordered 2 boxes of 8. Now, normally when you buy bottles, they come in like a little... and J-Tabs joins. Normally when you buy bottles, you know, obviously it comes in like a little case or something, doesn't it? No, it was a box with 8 individual bottles. All individually wrapped with like a little inflatable jacket. It was amazing. Literally, it was like an armband around each bottle. And yeah, they put 8 in one box and sent me a second box with 8 in that. I was like, okay, fine. But yes, I now have that this lovely Welsh cider. It's absolutely delicious. I was going to say the problem is, it's not a problem at all. The bottles are 500 milliliter, so they're bigger than usual bottles. So it's half a litre. So you know, you do tend to drink a lot more cider than you were originally planning, but that's not really a problem. It's only a little bit bigger. Why no face cam lately? There's a couple of reasons to that. One, I'm doing a little bit of a tidy up and nothing's really connected. I haven't got my green screen set up. I haven't got any of the lights set up. Otherwise, I'll just look like a dark silhouette in the corner. So that's one reason. The other reason is I don't have the motivation to set that up with the current temperature, because it's so warm that I don't want the lights on me as well, if that makes sense, because those lights don't half give out quite a bit of heat. But it's still there. It still will be a thing. It's just not at the moment. I just haven't got around to sorting all that out at the moment. But it will be back. Don't worry. I know it's very nice to think that you miss my face, but fear not. And of course, because I'm in a closed off room with the computers going really hot and a fan blaring at me, I am a little bit hot as well. So you don't want to see a little perspiration all over my face. You don't want to see that. So it's probably better this way. Oh, shall I go forward a bit? Let you do your turn. There we go. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Right, I'm empty. Good evening, Red Kite. How are you, sir? Right, I think we're going to park these up and we need to go and do... Woo! It's a class race. I'm not sure where we're going to park these, but let's park them up. We obviously got some straw to collect. I guess we're probably collecting it. Fields to work. And we have to go and see what equipment we've got, actually. I don't actually know the full extent of our equipment listing tonight. We'll have a look. Oh, yes, the tyres that are rebuilt every time you go past. I remember those. All right. Is there no... Oh, has he not bought... Patrick, do you know, I'll give you permission to buy a washer if you want to put it in the washing bay. Go on, you can do it. I don't want to take the responsibility just in case Andy gets mad. So, by all means, you do it. Found the cider. Yeah, there is a £10 delivery or £10-12 delivery because they send it by FedEx. However, that's only a one-off payment. So it's worth buying two or three crates in one go because you only pay one delivery. If that makes sense. Yeah. It's really nice. It's a really it's 6.6%. Let me tell you. Let me read the back. It's made in Swansea. It's a premium dry cider suitable for vegetarian diets. Well, I never. There we go. Suitable for vegetarians. Proofreading my master's dissertation before handing it in tomorrow. Oh, I'm sure you'll be fine, Red Kite. I'm sure you've done all the due diligence on it and it's going to be awesome. I have every confidence in you, my friend. Every confidence in you, my friend. Oh, that's pretty cool, isn't it? As you close the top box, the ladder comes down. I like that. Am I getting for a clean? Just put these away clean, because, you know, they're not ours, so we... Oh, hang on, look at him with his 218 class, and me and just my 208. Oh, I've got an old model, have I? Or a smaller model? I don't know the difference, to be honest with you. I love how every time you get out, you're actually on top of the cab, which is quite amusing. Right. Oh. Sorry. My mouse hit the beer bottle, or the cider bottle. Let me just move that to one side so I can actually move my mouse again. Did anybody watch that Top Gear where they actually took a... I think it was a Dominator, and they made a snowplow out of it and a gritter. Ah, it's pretty good. Jeremy Clarkson had his unique way of measuring the depth of the snow by jumping in head first. Oh, and he hit some ice. That was so funny. That was so funny. And they had a flamethrower as well, didn't they? So their grip would come out of here. They obviously took this off and had a big snow plow on it. And at the spout, they had a big flamethrower. It was something else. It was something else. It was good fun. Yeah, it was a good episode. Wait and see how Grand Tour will be. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it'll be more of the same, to be honest with you. I'm fairly confident. Oh, hang on. Whack on. I'll just give some instructions. I think that's been so long since I played this map, I could be giving some misdirection there. Right. Excellent. I think, let me just get back with this map to make sure. Yeah, so this is, whoop. Oh no, this is the... Oh, yes. Listen to Patrick. I'm talking rubbish. This is the wood chips and the grass and the straw storage. Yeah, it's over there. Yeah. God, I played this map for like a year. How can I have forgotten so quickly? Right. Okay, let's collect some straw. That was... Good God, that's loud. Hang on, let me just turn that down a bit. Wow, it's so loud. Oh, I'm sorry if I'm killing everyone's ears with this. Come on, little baby. I do like these little Massey Fergusons, though. Yeah, regarding Grand Tour, I think it's going to be fine. It's going to be more of the trio doing silly things. they probably got a better budget with Amazon as well. And of course, they're not bound by all the bureaucracy that the BBC tends to have. So I think they'll be a lot more free to do what they want to do. Whether or not it's going to be... Obviously, everyone's going to be comparing it to Top Gear, which is very understandable. I don't think there's any coincidence that the Grand Tour is, you know, the Top Gear initials the other way around. But yeah, no, I think it'll be fine. I think it'll be entertainment. You know, those guys tend to be quite amusing in their own stupid ways. So we'll see what mischief they get up to. I'm fairly looking forward to it. It's got a fare better than the new series of Top Gear, because that did not go down particularly well. It was okay, but it wasn't the triumph that they were hoping it would be, I don't think. You might have to order a selection of beverages, not just the cider. Yeah, yeah, as I say, it's best to get a big bulk buy. It's, it works out better. As I said, they come individually packaged, which is a bit silly. Good evening, Joe Dev. How are you, sir? Good to see you. How's your cat? Rocky? Oh, he's noisy as ever. He's fine, thank you for asking. I'm sure if he... Oh, he's outside. That's all. I can see him on the patio table. Sort of just stretched out in the last... I was going to say rays of the evening sun, but it's kind of a bit overcast. But he's just stretched out in the warm breeze outside, which is quite good. Haven't seen you lot in a while. All doing okay? I'm doing very well, Joe Dev. Thank you for asking. I just hope they keep it doing odd, silly, big challenges like across the channel and the floating pickups. That was brilliant. That was one of my favourites. That was... Oh, and the hover van. You've got to remember the hover van. That was superb. I think it's safe to say Chris Evans was a mistake for Top Gear. There's no denying he... Well, I don't think it was necessarily a mistake. I just think he needed to do his own thing. He was just trying to do what Jeremy Clarkson does. It's like, no, be your own man and do your own thing. But I think he just got stuck on the old Top Gear identity and he tried to continue it, which was a mistake. And I think they kept it too close. I know people are saying keep it close to the old format with just a few changes. But I thought they were better off doing a completely new, motoring entertainment show, and call it something different. They could have done exactly the same. Well, change it up a little bit more, and just don't call it Top Gear, so that it's not being compared. It'll always be compared to it, but it's you could then given a chance of having it judged on its own merit, but. What has been, so there's no point worrying about it, you know. Oh, guess you forgot to put the thingy down. Control plus space. There we go. Sorry, we're all struggling with the drive control this evening. Right, let's try that again. This time picking up the straw, brilliant. Yeah, I always skip the celebrity in a car bit as well, you know. Not really interested in that. You know, some of them were quite funny, but it was all the challenges, it was all this silly stuff. It wasn't really a motoring program. I didn't really want to see car reviews. I just wanted it to be entertained. And And that's really what Top Gear excelled at, in my opinion anyway. Because it used to be quite a boring car review program. I say not quite boring, but quite a stale program which just did everything like that. There is only... Hello, RJ, good evening. Hello, sir, how are you? Good to see you, bud. Hope you had a lovely day. There's only one Jeremy Clarkson. Yes, there is. And even though I find him hilarious, I'd also say thank God. We couldn't have more than one Jeremy. Yup, somebody else is coming in. Gives me time to have another bit of cider. I noticed that you posted some of the stream recording last week. Does this mean you're back to a regular-ish? Hopefully, Joe Deb. Yeah, I'm trying to get back into regular. Summer was absolutely crazy. Ethan has joined. Hello. Hi, Ethan. Grab yourself some equipment and fire away. Doesn't matter what you want to do. Just help yourself. There's plenty to do. What was I saying? Oh yes, I'm trying to get back to a semi-regular thing. So we're going to do Wednesday night farming, and we're going to rotate between the classic farm server and my farm server as well, just to keep things a little bit different, and so it's not the same thing every week. Hopefully, when time and things permit, we'll be doing some more streams. Hopefully, bringing back, you know, maybe some Friday night streams. But at the moment, it's a little bit tricky with certain issues. I would like to do something on... I would ideally like to do Monday, Wednesday and Friday, but I just don't have the time, unfortunately. And I have another full load. Oh my goodness, I am the straw king. The straw collection king. Look at me go. One too many ciders, I think. No. I've only had half a cider. And that's in 40 minutes, so, you know. And I'm trying... I always drink it quicker to begin with, because it's nice and cold at the moment. I may need to go and get a glass and some ice, because obviously, sitting in the room with all the computers, it tends to slowly warm up, which is still nice, but it's... Oh my goodness. I must have killed... like half the ozone layer with this tractor. It's smoking like nothing on earth. Apparently the US Top Gear is a lot better, and they became a three car challenge series. Oh, okay. Yeah, because they got, you know, they got the German one as well, haven't they? Oh, do they? Because it used to be Shabina Smith, but she's moved over to... whatchamacallit, to the regular Top Gear. That was the other thing. The new Top Gear, I don't want to go on a rant, but the new Top Gear came out with like all these, there's like seven presenters. Only any of us ever saw Chris Evans and Matt LeBlanc. What happened to Sabina Smith? I'm sure, I saw her like for like 2 minutes on one short video sequence, or it's probably an exaggeration, maybe 5 minutes, but it's like, oh. I know people like love Matt LeBlanc and that, but I found him quite... I don't know if it was him or it was the script, but I found it quite dry and quite... But beyond... I don't mind a dry script, as long as it's quite funny but and edgy, but I just found it dry and a bit old and stale. And Chris Evans I just found it a bit annoying. He just kept... I just thought he was shouting at you all the time. And I quite like Chris Evans on many things, but... Stop shouting at me! Maybe it was just a really loud studio he was in, that's why he had to keep shouting. But I don't know. I shouldn't complain, I only watched like 2.5 episodes and I switched off. I just couldn't be able to keep watching it, so I'm probably not the best. It may have improved towards the end, I didn't see it. I shouldn't criticise too much. ultimately a stopgap until the Grand Tour starts. Yeah, that was my feeling as well. Ooh. Almost had a bit of a collision. Thankfully, the brakes on this Massey Ferguson are electric. They are fantastic. Or the fact that it doesn't go very far. Oh, we're doing 13 miles an hour. That's its top speed. That could also be the other reason why it stopped incredibly quickly. It feels like you're going a lot quicker. It's like if you've ever been in an old school Mini, it feels like you're going incredibly quick in one of those, but you're not. You're just really low to the ground. Oh, Eddie Jordan was on there, was he? Didn't see him. But then I didn't see much of it, to be honest with you. Yeah, don't worry, Joe Davis. Basically, the classic server is this is Dynamite Andy B's server, who's kindly well, we were having a chat, and he goes, "Yeah, yeah, he'd quite like to get the community up on this one as well." So he's renamed it from Dynamite Andy B to the Classic Farm server, just so everyone know can find it, basically, which is very kind of him. And so we are amply trying to help him out as well by doing the harvests and. Spending his money. Well, that's Patrick spending his money, to be fair. I just encouraged him a little bit. But it makes a nice change coming back to this older, smaller equipment. It means you do a lot more work, but it's quite fun as well. I think I recognise North Brabant. Yes, it's North Brabant. The other map we usually play on is Chellington 2015 Extended. Yeah, it's a great map. It's really is one of my favourite maps, although, you know, I'm happy to change it. Oh look, I'm so far in the chat, everyone's answered the question before I even got there. Sorry guys. I'm like 20 minutes behind everyone else. Call it the go-kart effect, yeah. It always used to be, the way, Monster. You're very right there. I used to, for a summer job when I was at college, back when I was 18, 19 or something, I got a summer job working for the council, basically. Well, it was a contractor, council contractor, and we did street lighting. And because I was 18, and the person who I was with was also with 18, but he didn't have a driving license. Guess who got the van? So yeah, I had a transit van with a cherry picker on the back, which is great fun. You know, it was only like a 30-foot cherry picker, but still, great fun. Straw is not accepted there. I beg to differ. There we go. It's accepted there though. So yeah, I spend all day driving this transit van with a cherry picker on the back around. Then I get back to base. And I jump in my car, and when I was 18 I had, some of you won't remember these, but it was a really nice car. It was a Vauxhall, or an Opel if you're in Europe, Calibra. Really nice car, really nice car. Low to the ground, a little bit of a sports car, well not sports car, it was a coupe. Really nice looking car at the time. Yeah, and it felt like driving a tank then getting into a Formula One car. It was like, oh my god! Terrified myself, I used to come home. And then I just decided, well, there's no point driving, I might as well take the van home, so I took the van home. It's not a bad job for an 18-year-old during your summer holidays. So that was good fun, actually. A lot of independence, earned quite a lot of money. And he got to play around with the cherry picker van all day. Great fun. No supervision as well. Ah, oh dear. It's such a shame I was so responsible. And I wanted to pay off my student loan. Yeah. Does he have the FS15 Classics pack installed? Could get a little self-contained forage wagon. Let's have a look. Let's have a look what we've got, shall we? I'm pretty sure he does, actually. So have a look in the mods. We've got all the old classic tractors, which I think is part of the classic pack. He's got the classic Fords, the TW10, TW30, the John Deere 4755, the lovely little Massey Ferguson, love this one, 698T with big old wheels on the front, and the an old version, which is what I'm driving now, the Environment Killer. What are we looking for? Oh, loading wagons. Was that what you're looking? Ah, this one. Is this the one you're referring to? The little yeah, that's quite a nice little truck you could get. We've also got slurries. We'll just go a full list of what we've got. Got the classic equipment. Oh, look at this old class header. That's a tiny little maze cutter. That's like 3.5 meters. My goodness, you might as well do it by hand. It'd be just as quick. Tippers, we've got some nice old little Marshall tippers. Fertilizers, got this little Amazon. Oh wow, oh, I remember these old mowers. I had one of these in Farms Agricultural Simulator 2013. They're brilliant. Baling technology. Is that a round baler? They haven't got a square baler. Do you remember the classic square balers? You don't see many of those around today. They used to be good. Good sized little bales for, especially if you had things like horses, you could sell the straw and the hay. Very useful. Combines, we've got, oh, look at that old class. It looks like the old Lizard one from Farm Sim 09, whatever it was. We've got the class 218. It's class 208, which I was driving. Oh, here we go, the lizards. Here they are. They're right here. Oh, nostalgia. Some cultivators. An old manure spreader and an old windrower. Oh, fantastic. Oh, I'd forgotten how loud that was. I'm actually looking forward to the new map in 2017. Not many American high quality maps out there, unfortunately. No, there's not. I remember, who was it? I think it was Shadowbox and Dr. Vesuvius were looking at a decent looking American map. I must admit, I tend to stick to like the British S, but then, because obviously that's how the farming I know. The huge open plains of America, that's kind of farming I never really gelled with. It's all like the small fields, nooks and crannies. Difficult to manoeuvre farmyards, that's my kind of farming. You know, you spend half the time trying to get the vehicle out of the farmyard, that's what's all about for me. But yeah, I get that people love the classic American style maps. Have I missed any derps? No, of course not. It's been smooth professional sailing, Sussex. What God, it's, what kind of outfit do you reckon take me for, honestly? I don't think I have any mistakes, actually. Amazingly. Stay tuned. I'm only half a bottle of cider down. It's plenty more fuel for fun. One thing you notice about these old tractors is that they're very light at the front. You sometimes turn, you have to wait a few seconds for like the front to actually make connection with the ground. Feels like that anyway. I want to get this little bit here. And we'll turn back on that spec. Oops, guess he was reading chat and completely missed his drive, yeah. I doubt you get away with that these days. What, my job? Probably not. I'm not that old, Red Kite, heaven's sake. Blimey. God. Ooh, there was a war on, you know. God, think standards were dropped. Honestly, no. Cheeky bugger. God. I still feel 19, sadly. The body doesn't anymore, mind. The brain does, the body doesn't. Luke, welcome back. Good to see you. As you can tell, I'm miles behind on chat. I do apologise. Is this clippable? No. Okay, great. We can drive straight through that. And we can almost... Will we get all this done in one... Hopefully we will. Yes, I think we will. I think we'll be lucky. 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95... 98%. Do we miss anything? No. There's a little bit in the corner, but there we go. Fantastic. Another job successfully achieved. Awful vehicle's always good fun. My mate had a Daihatsu mauve in red brown with silver bumpers. Felt like it was made of cardboard and leaned into the... The turns are low. Oh, that sounds wonderful. Oh, the window reminded me. Has anyone seen farmers in real life using windrowers? They have their blades set vertically instead of lowered. Yes, I think you're right, actually. You are right, yes. I have, obviously, when I grew up, my sisters and my mum, my family is very equestrian, you know, they always had horses and ponies and stuff. I was not interested at all. Racing cars and motorbikes, that's what I was interested in. But we did have some fields, which obviously we used to grow, and then the local farmer would come and cut and bale for us for hay. And obviously he used to windrow it to dry the grass out to dry into hay. And yes, you're absolutely right. The blades used to be sticking upwards. Now you come to mention it. Are you for the open American maps? Surely you remember my driving skills on the British maps. Ah, that's the half the fun. Ah, Luke's still struggling with the old internet. Don't worry, mate. If you can't, you know, it's causing problems. Don't cause yourself any frustration. Driving and reading text. Ah, it's a challenge. Oh, you're referring to the overbearing health and safety and legal nonsense. Had to sign a contract to drive a glorified electric golf cart to work some time back. Really? Oh, gone are the days. Gone are the days. Oh, anyway, talking about your mate's Daihatsu. One of my mates had an old bright red laser. It was a Capri laser. Oh, it was an amazing car. You didn't drive it, you aimed it, because yeah, it really was all over the place. Amazing looking car though. Not in a good way, but they were something special. They're a bit of a British icon, but obviously he got it in the early 2000s, which is, you know, it's quite an old car by then. But my goodness, that was we had some fun times in that. As I say, if it was wet, he'd boot it, and God knows, you'd be fishtailing all the way down the street. It was really good fun. Of course, that was back when we were students, so I used to put, you know, like £4 worth of fuel in it to get up the city for the Saturday night. Oh, how poor we were. Good old days. I used to go out with £30, and that would see you all night. £30 of beer and club entrance fees, and that was it. Now you're looking at a ton every night, aren't you? So it's ridiculous how much it costs these days. I'm not sure if no amount of washing will get this rust off. You need a wire brush or something. I think that's as good as she's gonna get. Yeah, I think that's I think she's just old, bless her. Second time's a charm, every time. Oh my goodness. Sorry. Sorry to anyone with headset. That'll probably deafen you. Right. We need to park this up because that's damn loud. Oh wait. Let me just have a look. Hang on. I just spotted something. Do we not have any cows? This is a dairy farm and we don't have any cows. What's the world coming to? Honestly. Let's go in the garage to see if we have any cows. No, we don't have any cows. Okay. Right. Oh my god, this is so loud. I guess. We only have 41,000 though, so I guess we probably don't have the money to invest in the cows yet. That's a great sound, isn't it? That's an engine that's done a hard life's labour. And clearly that's the reason the reversing is not going particularly well. There we go. Oh yes. Dun 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 dun. Oh, sounds beautiful. Ticking over, purring like a kitten, as they say. Right, let's just see if there's anything in here. No, the workshop's empty. Okay. Let's just have a look around then. I just want to see. Oh, we got some Fords. Okay. So we'll put this noisy beast away because I think we've killed half the environment driving this for the last 10 minutes. So we'll just pop her away for a second. Handbrake on, put her in forward drive, and we'll come over to these because I saw some Fords in here. Right. So we got the lovely the Ford TW30 or the Ford TW10. What do you reckon, everyone? What do we want to do, actually? We're probably going to do... we're probably going to do some seeding, so I'm thinking the TW30 will probably be better for that. No offence, TW10. Right, is that connected or disconnected? Disconnected, brilliant. Right. Oh! There we go, drive control wasn't working. There we go. Ooh. Now this is a beast. Now, I had a model one of these when I was a kid. Like a toy. And what the whole section from... Actually, can I jump out? So the whole section from just behind this grate in the middle. So where that kind of weird little thing is, where the Ford sticker is peeling off. This whole section going down there, and the front used to peel off, and you used to stick a battery in it, a AA battery, and then you put the front back on, and then a little switch at the back here, and it would actually drive itself, so you had automatic cruise control on it. It was only a, you know, it's like a 6-inch model, you know, the model toys used to get. Anyway, that was a, sorry, I did a flashback about that. That's a random bit of information for you, which you could probably all live without, but it's in your head now. We'll take the clean one. I don't think there's any difference between these two. Apart from this one's empty. Is that clipping my rear tyres? That's not going to be a problem. Don't worry. Just ignore that. Right. We'll fill up. Let's have a quick drink and a catch up on chat. The first experience with cars was the big family wagon. Oh, you see, I think American cars are famous for those, kind of for those like station wagons. Mainly through watching things like the, oh come on, National Lampoon. Is it National Lampoon's Vacations when they all go in the station wagon? Is it? Oh, I could be getting that completely wrong. But things like that, you know, these huge, massive cars. Oh, wheat. Apparently we're doing wheat because I forgot to have a look about what the other options were. So we're going to do wheat in this one. All okay. All cool and groovy. Does this have... Oh, it does look... Oh, nice. Let's try and keep this on track. The front is very light on this. You can see it's dancing all over the place. It's not rust, Taff. It's character. It's experience. It's life. Yeah. It's rust. Oops. Yeah, you think with the engine on this, I guess that is quite a big implement to be on the back of this tractor. This big blue nose on this thing is massive. You can get a normal size car to your 30s, blimey. Did you have like a captain's hat as well? I always used to have a mate, you know, considering we were in our 20s, he had this huge, what was it? It was like a Rover 800. It was like, you know, it was like an oil tank of the size. It was massive. It's probably very similar to what you were driving, Monster. And we always used to call him the captain because he was basically steering a ship every time he went somewhere. Aye, aye, Captain. Oh, I thought that would all sort of lighten up together, but it didn't. We might have to go back and tidy that piece up later if my OCD kicks in and won't allow me to leave it. Excuse me, as I choke. Obviously not drinking enough. Throat's getting dry. Oh, I keep pressing the wrong key. I keep pressing B when I can just lift it. I'm getting a hold of this drive control at last. Now, let me have a quick drink before I choke myself to death. Oh, that's better. Captain hat. Yeah, I think you should get a captain hat. That'd be great. I had a Merc was giant. Don't know the length, but it was longer than my dad's truck. Wow. It's funny, when I went to on holiday a couple of weeks ago, I was sitting at the ferry, and you know when you get off a ferry and you have those like three or four queues all filtering into like one passport control booth. It's like, oh god. I remember there was a queue next to me that had a really old Merc in it. One of those classic Mercedes estates from like the 80s. It really is like a tank. It's huge. It was dented to pieces. It had a family in it, you know, it's still being used as a family car, but it's dented like anything. And my goodness, but the, you know, I guess they built them better back then. I suppose if you got a family and you want a big car on a budget, you can't go wrong with a tank. Obviously safety is your premium concern. You always get the name zipping round the screen, don't you? It's always slightly disconcerting. It's one of the unique aspects of multiplayer and farming. Something bizarre. It could be people obviously skipping round... Oh, I missed another bit. Skipping round the various vehicles. But obviously there's Patrick, his name I saw flipping around. He's in the Massey over there, cultivating the ground up for us. Straight for the fence, clunk. There we go. Ah yes, I had the old 70s floaty suspension. Ah, those are good. It's like, do you remember the old Citroens? Like, they're almost like pointy at the front and they went on for about 2 miles at the back. And they had really soft suspension. They used to use them at the horse races because their suspension was so soft. They used to mount cameras on the top so a man could be filming the horse racing. So you'd get the smoothest shot with the Citroen. Yeah, so if you ever watch any 80s or 90s horse racing, you'll probably see a car blasting around the inside of the track with a cameraman on the top. It's usually a Citroen. Because the infield track was always a bit rubbish anyway. But yeah, I saw millions of those. That was one of the lovely, charming things when I went to France. I haven't been to France for ages. But they have all the old Citroens, all the old Peugeots, all the old Renaults. They're still running out there. They are still running out there. Like Renault 5s. I haven't seen a Renault 5 for years until I went to France. Two CVs. Deux Chevaux. There's millions of them. Millions of them. I haven't seen them since the 90s in the UK. Wonderful little cars. My mum had a 2CV. Fantastic. You could go, you know, 50 miles an hour on the road and 50 miles an hour across the field. It was exactly the same. The ride was so smooth, and the whole roof used to just come off. It was just like a soft top roof. You just take it off. It was brilliant. We used to live near Chepstow, which is on the Welsh Gloucester border. Yes, I used to live near Gloucester. And when I was about 4 or 5, and every time we used to go over the Bristol Bridge, which is a huge suspension bridge, you used to have to hold onto the roof because the winds ripped it off. It's always quite exciting. Sorry, it's regressed into some bizarre tangent then. Sorry about that. don't know where that came from. Talking about old cars, probably. So not to hijack the conversation, what about Minecraft? Yeah. So, okay, Minecraft update. I played it the other day. I lasted about 4 minutes. It wasn't helpful that I spawned at night time, I don't think. I killed a zombie, and then some wizard thing killed me. And I just about managed to build a wooden sword, so I was very disappointed at that fault, and then I rage quit. We will be doing the Minecraft stream. I need to talk to you, Monster, about the message you sent me. Again, I always say it's time. I never seem to have enough time. I'm always busy doing things. Yes, we may hijack a Wednesday night and do a Minecrafty thing then, just to see what's what. Just saw a random thread on Reddit. 131 years ago today, Emmett Doc Brown was shot in the back over $80. Rip Doc. Oh, as in Back to the Future. Oh, awesome. Ah, Rip Doc. Rip Doc.
My greetings to you, one.
Luke Scott 02 is following. Welcome, Scott. What has he got? What is an 02? He changed your account? Welcome, thank you for the follow, buddy. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Luke Scott's back. Is this with your new internet? Super duper internet, sorted. Yeah, that 4 minutes was me. I built a workbench. I figured that out. And I made a sword and a spade. And I lasted